there now. All right. Love you. Bye.
Check.
Mic check, 1, 2, 3.
Mic check, 1, 2, 3.
Sounds good. Sounds good. We've got levels.
Let's put that right here.
If we can, just because I want to
use the camera. Yeah,
take pictures. Maybe she can
put it over there for me. Come on, Beyonce.
I just have all my winter garb when it's so cold outside. I mean,
where are you from?
Yeah.
I grew up in Iowa.
Oh, okay. You're used to the cold.
Yeah. Maybe not quite this cold. I'm actually from San Bernardino, California, but I've been in Iowa since I was 8. Probably.
Okay.
Wisconsin's a different cold.
Yeah.
A lot more snow,
I'm originally from Minnesota, actually. Northern Minnesota, so it's even worse.
Minnesota is so cold.
always.
Yeah,
like,
I went to Drake
University.
You go to the game?
What's that?
You go to the game in Minnesota?
No.
You can count me out.
Especially now that they play outdoors. Yeah. I went to one game at that stadium when it was a couple years ago when they first opened it, because it's for their college team, and it was like October, but it was like we were way up a high, and it was windy, and it was like, oh, God, this is way too cold, so.
All right, we are rolling, so.
Okay.
All right, well, I'll just ask you something. This will be real conversational. Yeah. I'm just ask you some general questions about the show and anything you guys want to throw in there, you know, that I don't ask. I mean, we can always post edit it and stuff, so it's not like we're live or anything like that. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if we're going to go back and throw some things at the end, that will be no problem at all. All right, check. All right, we are ready to go. All right. And Rosie, I just want to make sure I get this right. You're the longtime girlfriend of Andrew Corliss.
Yes, the better half.
Okay, the better half. I'll say that. The better half. I just want to make sure I get that right.
It sounds so much better, you know? It's like my signature.
Absolutely. All right. And having you're the wife of Mike.
I'm catching up, you know?
She's fine. She's
good. No, it's all good. Check. Okay, here we go. And we're talking to Rosie Sierra, who's the better half of Packers player Andrew Corliss, along with Heaven Daniels, the wife of Mike Daniels. Welcome, ladies.
Hello. Thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing great. I hope you guys are staying warm today.
We're trying.
We're cozy. We have our scarves, hats.
Yeah, we're layered up.
Now, Heaven, we were talking before that you're from Iowa. You are from California originally, but you spent a lot of time in Iowa.
Yep, correct. Mike actually says I can't claim California. I've been in Iowa too long, so I'm from Iowa.
And Rosie, where are you from?
I'm from Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love. So they say.
Yeah. I bet you that went interesting for you last week.
I know. It was the pressure. I got so many messages. I got so many... my news feed was going off, but I just kept quiet and I let, the game speak for itself. So.
And it certainly made a statement, didn't it?
Yes.
Nice to be on the winning end of one of those games, huh?
Well, it felt good.
We're here for The Better Half, which is a television show that airs locally on Fox 11 every Friday at 10 o'clock. Tell us a little bit about The Better Half.
Well, I can't say enough great things about it. If you're interested in food, fashion, football, family.
Arts and crafts and just... silliness.
Having fun. Yeah. It's definitely a show you want to check out.
Well, you got to stay tuned for the rest. We can't give you all the details.
That's a clever tease.
Yeah, we got to save the best for last. Oh, and surprise guests. We have special appearances, so.
You never know who could pop on the show.
So we're talking
maybe some cooking lessons. We get to find out what happens in the kitchen at the homes of some of the players.
Yes.
Yeah, the recipes are actually really awesome because everyone brings different things. And actually, that's where I got a lot of my cooking recipes from the show.
I'm more like the complicated one. I make all the dishes that are from Caribbean dishes to Italian dishes. I have all the ingredients. I'm the herb girl.
The herb girl. Hey, we'll take it, right?
Yes.
As long as it tastes good,
we're happy. Herbs, yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So you talk about that, a little bit of the stuff that happens in the kitchen, but what else does this show get into, I guess?
Well, we focus a lot on community stuff as well. It's basically an insight look at the Packer wives and spouses, better halves, what we do, how much we're involved in the community, what we do with our friends, our kiddos and stuff.
Yeah, it just keeps you relevant and up to date with what we do and what we do with the community. And just kind of, I think it's a great way to make a circle with everyone, let them know that we're just the same. We're just like you.
And it's shed a positive light on, there's a lot of negative things associated with sports and better halves. It's not all negative. We We have good friendships.
And we also have full-time jobs.
That's
so,
right.
That's what, you know, the show is all about. And you just got to stay tuned. It airs on at 10 in the morning, WLUK, on Fox 11.
Yep. That's awesome. Tell me about, I'm sure there's some outtakes that happened during the show. What are some of the favorite memories that you guys might have that maybe didn't make it to the camera?
Honestly,
the bar.
They usually make it to the camera. We try to keep it rolling. So unless it's a huge mistake, we just keep it moving. So you
really never know what you're going to get.
If you see us laughing on set when it starts, probably happens.
They keep recording, and then we stay tuned just like everyone else on Friday, and you never know
what
you're
going to get.
So this is nowhere near like a Desperate Housewives or a Real Housewives. It's not the Real Housewives of Green Bay at all.
No.
Right?
It's real fact that, you know, we're very genuine on the show. I think we do a really good job at showing what we do, especially as mothers and spouses, but it's not the drama you see on those shows. Absolutely not.
The real life drama.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I know, right?
It's all positive. Well, that's great. Tell us about some of the things that you two specifically do in the community.
Go ahead.
Okay. Well, we both are involved with the
PWA, Packers Women Association.
Packers Women Association. I'm on the board for the community shelter. We feed every year. We feed the shelter. Once a year, we cook for about 300 people. Mm-hmm. So that's really important to me. We also give back to the community. We do Paul's Pantry. We do breast cancer awareness. Anything you could think of for every month that there is, we do. So that's what I've been doing. A lot of community service. We do a lot of just giving back. If, you know, people need donations, we try to donate things. That's what we do in my family. We try to get rid of everything in the closet and give back to people because you never know who can need it the most. So,
And I'm actually in charge, along with Audie Perry, of Care for Kids this year. And we're actually transforming a room into a teen room at the Golden House Shelter. And we're actually doing the unveiling tomorrow, which we're really excited about to kind of do that for them because they really needed it. So, and then I'm a mom, so I'm really busy all the time.
How many kids do you have?
I've got 2, a 1-year-old and a 3-year-old, exactly 2 years apart, and their birthday is on family night.
And I have a 4-year-old. His name is Aiden, so he's a little junior.
Yeah.
He's like the mini him. And then I also am the secretary of Andrew's charity event.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Rise Up Future Leaders. So I think it's interesting to do. So you'll hear more about that later.
Okay. All right. A little tease of things to come. Yeah. We like that. What have you learned? I mean, there's more than just you two on the show. What have you learned from some of your fellow co-hosts, I guess? Co-workers, you could say? Co-better halves?
Actually, I can say I've learned a lot from all the women. Every woman has something different that they're interested in or that they bring to the table. And the more we are around each other, the more you kind of learn people's interests and likes. And then we kind of find, oh, we have this in common, or I should get involved here. Like, you kind of learn their interests, and it makes you more interested. So it's I don't know. I can't give an exact answer, but I would say it's a lot. That
I would say from a personal skill, like she said, you kind of learn from each other. I've learned, you know, some things along the way, like patience. I've learned to listen. But you just learn a lot from people. You learn about how people have different careers, their interests, their passion. And you just,
think about it. We're all from different places. So it's kind of like a melting pot. You don't know everyone's personality. Mike is from New Jersey. Drew's from New York. Some people from California. You bring all that together when the players and the wives, it can be a little crazy.
It's like a box of chocolate.
Never know what you're going to get.
Yeah, never know what you're going to get.
So I've always wondered this, from inside your home's standpoint, talk about what game day is like when you're with a Packers player. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on it. It's an exciting time. There's a lot of focus. I mean, I can't imagine what it would be like, you know, from a real stance point of view.
I would say game week. And I mean, always, but definitely game weekend and game day. Mike is always the kind of intense person. He's very passionate about what he's doing. But when it comes to game time, I'm talking about Mike turns into like a little crazy person, you know. He's got his little rituals and things he does, you know, get himself going before the game. So I just kind of let him be in his zone. If he needs something, I'm like, right away, here you go, honey. You know, I want him to perform well and be able to stay focused on, you know, the task at hand, which is winning.
Yeah. Well, Drew, he has a passion in music. So he kind of uses his music as his therapy to kind of get him ready for the game. And so I would say that's what he does. He listens to his music, and, you know, he's into fashion, too. So he always has to make sure he has the right outfit on for the game. That makes him feel feel good. So, yeah, it's really the music, and then we say our prayers as well. We both do in our
prayers,
family.
Yep, prayers,
prayers come first. So yeah,
that's awesome. Now I know I have young kids in my house, and I can imagine, you know, sometimes I come home from a stressful day at work, and it's a little bit crazy. I can imagine, you know, both before and then after a game, you know, win or lose, there's. You're emotionally drained after a game, and to come home to young kids who don't really understand that, you know, dad just got off the football field and he's exhausted. They just want to play. Tell us, like, kind of behind the scenes how you as better halves and the players, your better or your least better halves, I guess, deal with it. Deal with that kind of thing with the kids.
Mike is really good about coming home. As soon as you come to the door, he almost speaks to them before he speaks to me. He's like, hey, Papa's home. And even if he's tired, he just digs deep, spends a little time with them. We may put him to bed. And I think after the games, he's so amped, he stays up anyways. He's going to be up all night watching film and stuff. But he makes that time with family first, maybe watch some cartoons, eat some pizza, and, you know, kind of have fun.
Yeah, we have similar situations. Some days we just want to get some food. Some days we just want to go straight home. But we take our son with us to all the games. And so he's pretty much worn out, whether we win or lose. But he still has energy. So what we'll do probably is play a little game with him, like a Lego game or something, read a book, and then... Then Drew will do his, like you said, his routine.
Yeah, go do his stuff. Yeah.
Go look at the, you know, his
That's
work.
So cool, I think, to think about that, that you just get off, you know, a nationally televised game. And, you know, an hour later, you're sitting there reading, you know, a Curious George book to your kid. And I just think that's such a cool dynamic to think about that, you know, these Packer players and, of course, their families, I mean, they're just like the rest of us.
It's crazy. I find myself saying to Mike, do you realize you just played in a Sunday night football game and now you're home and we're doing this? He's like... Yeah, I never really think about it, you know, but it is. It's like so fast, and I think they just get used to it. They don't take time to really enjoy and sit back and think about it, but I think the spouse is kind of like, wow, that's awesome, and then you come home and you give us your energy, which is cool.
Well, I think whether we win or lose, Aiden just makes Drew happy, so
yeah.
I think that's always their highlight. After the game, they look forward to seeing their family.
Even more so after they lose,
probably. Even after, yeah. Because then, like my son, he always says, Daddy, I'm proud of you. You did good.
Right.
And, you know, so I think that just makes it all better. They're the biggest fans, so it can't get any better than that.
That's absolutely right. Isn't that, that's the joy of having children. That's awesome, though, because I think so many people who, you know, watch the show and listen to the radio are in that same situation, too, at their jobs. And it's just like, you know, you guys are living the same lives, just with different types of careers, I guess, than the rest of us, so to speak.
No, and that's what I try to – we're normal people. We're just blessed that our spouses are able to do exactly what they love, their dream job. You know, a lot of people wish they could do or be in that position to do that. And you know what? It's just a blessing, but we're really just regular,
regular Janes. We just,
you can find us anywhere. It doesn't last forever. So enjoy it while you can.
Yeah, we try to stay.
Prepare for the future.
Yeah, you want to kind of stay grounded because, like she said, it's not going to always be there. So you need to make sure you can stay true to yourself and have an identity continuously so you're not looking for that identity later.
And that's one reason actually we both do the show. You know, we got to have things for us to do as well. And that kind of gives us an outlet to go and be with other ladies who kind of live a similar lifestyle and connect and then kind of, you know, give you guys a little bit of how crazy it is.
Yeah.
All right, Rosie Sierra and Heaven Daniels, thank you so much. The Better Half, again, it's on Fridays at 10 o'clock on WLUK, Fox 11, and statewide on network affiliates around Wisconsin. Thank you so much for
taking
time.
Thank you for tuning in. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Stay tuned.
Awesome.
That was really good. Cool. We're going to take some pictures really quick.
Okay, sure. Awesome.